Good. Okay. So, this antelope, basically, this is like a, like if this was upside down, like that, but on the other side, courtesy of Trey Vanderpool. He's like my homie from school. He's pretty good looking for a dude. So like, but I don't want to, I mean, I kiss him on the mouth, but I don't want anything else to do with him. But he brought this fucker back for me. So, cause he's like hunting master. This is an antelope. This is a fucking antelope. This is literally an antelope. Do not edit out my cuss words, or do not edit out that part either. You understand me?
Okay.
Good. Okay, so basically what we're gonna do is I'm gonna just like, see that? Where like creases? Use my fingers a little bit. So an antelope, which is something I'm very familiar with. I'm lying. Last night was the first time I ever tried it. But it's very close to venison. As in flavor, and pretty much all animals like that, their anatomy is going to be the same. So this is your leg. So you're just going to like cut this off, just like so. Now you're always going to like feel some joints. So I just like to kind of like, I let gravity do the job. You know what I'm saying? Like, and then once you get to that point, usually, you can kind of like break it off, but that fucking antelope's got some muscle, man. I mean, the leg has nothing to do with muscle, but. So I'm gonna just kinda bite on it for a while. Just joking. But, Trey, I thought you said this thing was dead. He's lying. So basically, like, think of like a cow shank. It's the same thing as this, except for this little fucker, like, runs all over the place all the time. Dude! It's so tough. Yeah, you might want to edit that part out. No, don't, actually. Oh. So, the Renaissance Festival the rest of the week, folks in my house. Isn't that funny? That's pretty funny. So, like, we'll save that. We'll braise that. And then, basically, I'm just going to start cutting this stuff away. Okay, so this right here, see this? So that knuckle, that's definitely what you want to save for like broth, because it's going to be super marrowy. So bone broth, which is like this, those over there, stock bone broth, whatever you want to call it, they're really good for us because it's like, it's good for our teeth, our nails, our hair, our skin, also promotes gut health. So anytime you take marrowy bones like this with a lot of collagen and things like that, especially pasture-raised animals or like wild game animals, like that shit's just good for us. Real talk, man. Real talk, man. And so basically, I'm just scraping away from the bone, like, just like so. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna start cleaning it up, silver skin. So what we're gonna start doing is we're gonna break this down the rest of the way. Like skinny skin. Oh shit. So I save this stuff for stock. Like this right here, I mean, I'm just gonna save that for stock too. I could ground it up, but I want that super flavorful stock. I can't tell you what cut this is because, I mean, I'm not a fucking antelope. But I can't tell you, if you just think of yourself as like how you would want to be cut up and just follow like the creases and things like that and just make sure you don't waste anything, you can kind of figure it out. Because that's really what it's all about. It's not about what type of cut of meat you get. It's about, like, if this animal is going to die for us, like, we should respect it and utilize every single bit of it. That's what it's really about. Silver skin right here. And once again, I take off a little bit more than most people because I want that flavor. You know, I'm not gonna like sit there and... The stock is the most important thing of all my food, so... I want some really strong broth out of this, so that's why I'm taking so much scraps off. So that's pretty sexy right there. And this is 100% like personal preference. Like, I don't, there's no textbook for this. Actually, I'll probably just save this. Like, that's gonna be my save pile. So when I do my cows, like, I don't waste, dude, I would like scrape every little bit of this like that. I mean, it literally takes me a week and just save every single little bit. Like, I'll actually probably pick through this later and pick every little bit of meat out of there. Just because, like, just how I am. We just ain't got all that time. So if you just scrape it off like that, that gets all that meat off there, just like so. See that? And then just kind of... pull that off, save that for stock. Yeah, boom. And this right here, Happy Kids Meal, McDonald's, chicken fingers, people. That's what it is. It's fucking antelope, I swear to God. That's false. I don't mean that. I could probably get sued for that, actually, probably. I could get sued for that, couldn't I? Could I get sued for that? McDonald's game. Yeah, erase that. I'm just joking. You have to erase a lot of this stuff. I don't know how. I mean, I'm just like, what do you want me to do? You have to erase that stuff. I have to be myself. Those people. Just joking. I'm just joking. Alright, so that's another nice little one right there. So a little bit more off there. Yeah, more. So what I want to do though is I want to braise some meat. So what I'm going to braise is these two pieces right here. So what we're gonna do is, first off, we're gonna cut this out. This is just like anything that you picture, your elbows, your knees, or all that shit. That's all this stuff. That's what all that is. Now, see, this could be split up into pieces because you see how it's separated, like just by the creases and like ligaments, you know, cartilage. What, I don't know, whatever you want to call it. You know, but I'm gonna leave it together. I'm gonna make it like a roast. Is basically what I want to do. So. What I am gonna do is kind of peel it back a little bit. And I don't want that flap right there because it's gonna overcook it. So most people make jerky out of this, but I think that's fucking disrespectful and I hate it when people kill animals just to make jerky out of them. So. So this is sea salt and maca powder. Maca is just regular sea salt, coarse sea salt. And then maca powder is, it's like, it grows in the Andes, I'm pretty sure, you know? It's a root, so it's a super, super strong antioxidant. They used to use it way back in the day because it's the only thing that can grow up at that altitude for like reproductive purposes. So it's not gonna like get you knocked up or whatever, like get me knocked up or get like her knocked up. But it's really good for us because it promotes just overall health for like human beings. And so what I do is I mix it with my salt. It's like a powder. So that way all my food gets like distributed with it evenly, you know, like, I don't know, could be fake, kind of like everything. It's not fake, it's real, it makes you feel better. I got pregnant 37 times last year. I mean, like, just like boop, like not good. So all I'm doing now is searing it in chicken fat to make sure that it sears in all the juices, all right? So I got a braising pan. So this is antelope, searing, cast iron, oop, chicken fat. Boom, right there. All right. This is garlic, mirepoix, celery, onion, carrot, garlic, and some chili. So I use banana peppers right here and a little bit of jalapeno. All right. So, more fat, chicken fat. Just like so. Garlic, red wine, just like so. And now this is a little something that I feel like would taste really good with the antelope, and that's cilantro infused maple syrup. 100% maple syrup, okay? I'm just gonna do a little bit of that. All right, is this a lamb, beef, chicken, pasteurized pork broth, like all sorts of broths, okay? All sorts of broths. We're just going to a brown free range chicken broth. Just like so, just like that, okay. Free range chicken broth, I make all these, just like so, just a little bit, just like all sorts of flavors. And now we don't have to obviously bring this to a bowl. It doesn't have to bring to a bowl, you know. We're just going to get it heated up a little bit, all that flavor in there, just like so, okay. And actually, I'm gonna start it off cold, so it's mixed. Just pour it over top. All right, you smell that flavor. Now, I don't like to cover my meats when I braise them, because the oven's on 225. What time is it right now? It's like midnight? It's midnight, right? What time is it?
12:24.
12:30. I'm gonna go to sleep after this. I'm gonna wake up probably 8 or 9, and I'm gonna pull it out of the oven. Just completely forget about it. And that's it. So I'm gonna cover this with plastic, I'm gonna cover it with foil, and then put the lid on it. Put it in the oven until I wake up. And that's it, man. That's braised antelope that I've never done before in my entire life. But tastes like the bee's knees. That's it. Okay? Hold shit, it's gonna be really good. Done. Done. I'm just gonna mix these. Am I still recording? Yeah, you still got me recording?
You're done?
I'm never done, baby.
Until next time?
I mean, you can leave it on. Just leave it on. Well, just wait. Antelope braising fun. You like that? We $2.25 for 9 hours, or whenever you wake up. This is actually a really beautiful song. All along. Oh man, that antelope would have rhymed. Antelope. Trey Vanderpool is boss. For bringing this home.
That's his other hunting buddy. He's a great guy. Yeah, that's good. You can shut it off now. I'm done. I'm ignorant as fuck. Just like shut it off. It's stupid. Just like completely just kill it. I hate your face.